Prince Harry and Meghan Markle are being criticized for cancelling fundraising events after Netflix deal. According to reports, the couple were scheduled to attend the fundraising event, which aims to raise at least 1 million euro for the Invictus Games Foundation. Sunday Times claims it's in his report that the event was initially scheduled to be aired on Amazon, which may deem as a direct competitor to Netflix. The Invictus Games, first held in 2014, was created by Harry to focus on wounded, injured, or sickly armed service members who participate in 9 sports, including wheelchair basketball, sitting volleyball, and indoor rowing.
I think there's been a lot of trolls around the Duchess and Duke of Sussex. And I think basically it's because...
Are we allowed to introduce them as that name?
No.
Yes, they're still...
They're not. Yeah. I think he is still. She's not.
They stopped being royal members of the family, but the title is still there, which is something Piers Morgan has been fighting against. That look, if you guys, there was a time that... Meghan spoke about people voting against Donald Trump, and Piers Morgan came out on his Twitter page saying that, look, you're not supposed to be talking about politics because you're going against the treaty between the US and the UK, right, about not speaking against the political parties and all that. If you really want to be partisan about speaking about political stuff, then you need to drop your title. So the titles are still there. They're not just royal members. Do you understand? So people are actually fighting against them, ripping off the title completely. And it's also news that they paid for their cottage at Frogmore, right? Which it's about £284,000 or something like that, and that they've paid for the apartment and all of that. And then people are saying that, look, if you're paying off all these things with your Netflix deals, can you as well just drop your title? So this is an ongoing conversation about the title being completely dropped. They are not royal.
Well, bringing it back to this story anyway, the cancellation, I mean, there are rumors that are saying they knew already about this Netflix deal coming, because the cancellation was done a week before the public announcement. And of course, people in the space are quite sad, because this is a platform or an organization that's supposed to be built on passion and trying to help people. But then, personally, I feel like you said, there's a lot of scrutiny for them, and I think they're threading a very new path that nobody has really done it, and they have to just find their foot for themselves. And right now, I think for them, it's a case of choosing between your livelihood and your passion. And it doesn't mean that at some point the whole fundraising event or whatever that can be done to keep the Invictus game going forward cannot come up and re-strategize. Okay. Yes, but if the deal they have with Netflix is going to be directly affected by them having to stream this event on Amazon, then it's just fair for them to want to cancel and go back to the drawing board to see how to collaborate with Netflix or any other platform.
That has been pushed on the media, but I think they've come out to say it many times now that has nothing to do with it. So when the program Invictus Game was scheduled, a lot of the revenue was focused on tickets. And since COVID came, it had changed that perspective. So this is their words, not mine, that it has nothing to do with Netflix, that the Netflix deal that they have doesn't disturb them from working with Amazon, quote unquote, and Invictus Game. That it has everything to do with the fact that they have to remake the whole plan again, go back to the drawing board and figure out how they're going to do the program. So it's the execution of the event that they've kind of like have their worries about. Obviously, you're not going to want to waste money, and they don't have that luxury of wasting money per se. So I feel like that narrative, again, like you guys have mentioned, is a bit of the same stereotypical approach towards this couple of being really critical of their works and their actions. And not everything was, it's not that simple. It wasn't because of Netflix. It was more because they didn't feel like it was going to do justice. They were not going to be able to execute the plans like they had because all their backings were on tickets. So, I mean, it's something that they can look at and reschedule. From what Meghan has said a couple of times on Twitter and even to, I think it was Daily something, one American, whatever.
Daily Mail?
No, the other one. Anyway, She said in a million times that she still wants to be part of the event, and they still want to work together, but they need to obviously regroup and everything. So getting another way, it's in the entertainment industry, it's not just this program or just them, getting another way to make income apart from ticket sales has been quite difficult. It's not impossible, but you have to obviously re-strategize to see how you can monetize the digital platforms that we have now in terms of streaming performances and all that type of stuff.
Yeah. This is not the first time it's been cancelled. It was supposed to hold in May and it was postponed. That was the word used at the time because of COVID-19. Yeah. So this time around, I don't know why the word cancellation is being used, but I'm still hoping that it's a postponement and there will be re-strategizing, like you said, and something can be done, even if it's not on Amazon. The point is raising money for the people who need the money. So whether it's streaming on Plus TV Africa anywhere, that's not the point. The point is make the money that needs to be made.
Which is what is confusing for me with this story. Is like, are they not talking to each other? Because that's what the guy from the Invictus game said, that even if that's the case, where, you know, maybe your Netflix deal is kind of like counterfeiting this whole thing, he should still be able to raise his hand to help these the community and stuff. But then they're also saying that that has never changed. So it's like,
I think there's a communication gap in the organization.
I'm not going to look at it as communication gap. I'm just going to look at it as people not realizing, people getting in their feelings and not realizing that their contracts that are binding different deals, right? If I signed for the Invictus game with Amazon and then suddenly I'm beginning to have something with Netflix, there's obviously conflict.
Yeah, but from what you might say, that's not the case.
So it's not because you have a deal with contracts
right now.
Amazon is only the only, they're not the lead, the champions of this program anyway. The only thing that they're doing is sales for tickets, which doesn't even exist anymore because you can't get that crowd in wherever they wanted to do it before. So it has nothing to do with that. I don't know why they're not. For me, what I'm seeing in the bigger picture is that they're both on the same page in terms of working for the community, which for me is the most important thing. They need to come together and, like you said, close that gap and have a conversation on how they could do that.
In as much as we think it's not about contract, there's certain clauses in different contracts. And different
but the paper said there's no clause.
Different contracts with different clauses, different clauses.
Fair, do you understand the clause more than you know of the contracts now? They're telling you that that's not the issue.
Are you guys going to let me finish? Or
okay, but finish. You need to go on a break there.
All right. So what I'm saying is that at the end of the day, when there's conflict of interest, there has to be going back to the drawing board, which is what they have said. And a lot of people feeling that they're cancelling this because of Netflix, it's not actually because of that. It's because different arrangement has to be made between both parties. It's as simple as that. So it is still ongoing, but there just needs to be an agreement between both parties, which is Amazon and Netflix. And that is what
there can't be an agreement between Amazon and Netflix, fam. These are two competitors.